Hello everyone, my name is Axel Marmoret and I'm here to present you the article entitled Convolutive Block Matching Segmentation Algorithm with Application to Music Structure Analysis. This work was carried out with Jeremy Cohen and Frédéric Barbeau. This work talks about music structure analysis and how to estimate structure from the audio signal of music. Precisely, we don't estimate structure from its waveform, but from the spectrogram of an audio music. And we don't try to estimate the whole structure, but only to find frontiers between sections, which is called boundary retrieval. So, how one could estimate musical sections? Mainly, algorithms in the literature follow two principles. The first one is called the homogeneity, or its counterpart is called novelty, and considers that segments are locally stationary. This may be explicited by this example. The second criteria is the repetition criteria. It considers that a segment is repeated across the song. Thus, it may be heterogeneous, but it has to be repeated through the song. This may be explicited by this example. Where the chorus is heterogeneous in itself, but is repeating across the song, which indicates that this is indeed a section. In both cases, it corresponds to notion of similarity and dissimilarity across the song. In this work, time is processed at the bar scale. Hence, starting from the original spectrogram of a song, and by estimating the downbeats in this song, we separate the content in barwise spectrograms, hence introducing a new time dimension, which is time t, in time at the bar scale, and the b bars corresponding to b different bars in the song. This content is reordered in a new matrix called the barwise TF matrix with two dimensions, a dimension B corresponding to bars and a dimension TF corresponding to frequencies at the bar scale. The hypothesis behind this processing is that boundaries are located on bars. From the barwise TF matrix X, we compute a barwise autosimilarity matrix A, which represents the similarity between pairs of bars in the song, and it depends on the similarity function S. In this work, we study three similarity functions, namely the cosine, covariance, and RBF for radial basis function. Examples of autosimilarity matrices with each of these similarity functions are presented below. In the end, the convolutive block matching segmentation algorithm, or CBM, is applied on autosimilarity matrices. The main objective of the CBM is to frame blocks of high inner similarity on the diagonal of an autosimilarity as presented here. This is probably the take-home message of this whole video. To this end, we assign a score to each possible segment in the song. So this score is obtained by weighting the autosimilarity values in the matrix, and concretely, we apply a convolution between a kernel matrix K, which is a weighting matrix, and the autosimilarity matrix A restricted to the current segment. To give a concrete example, let's take the segment 4060 here. We restrict the autosimilarity values to this segment, and we apply a kernel matrix K. Here, three examples of kernel matrices are presented. To this convolution score, we add a penalty term which will enforce some segment sizes in particular, given prior knowledge. Now, given all segment scores, the segmentation is found as the segmentation which maximizes the sum of all segment scores. This is framed as the longest path retrieval problem in a graph, and is solved by dynamic programming. To give a visual example, let's consider the case here with four bars, each represented by a node, and edges which correspond to segments between bars. Here, the optimal segmentation is the segmentation B1, B3, B4, because it corresponds to the longest path in the graph. While this algorithm is relatively simple, it obtains performances which are close to state-of-the-art algorithm, as presented here on the Salami dataset. We only show here one result, but more results are presented in the article. The CBM algorithm is an open-source algorithm. This is important to us, and we invite you to take this algorithm, to test it, and to integrate it in your pipeline if you ever want to. So, to wrap up, let me state a few conclusions about this work. In this article, we have presented a new segmentation algorithm. This algorithm is of low complexity and can be easily customizable, for instance, on the shape of the kernels or the penalty function. This algorithm obtained high performances which do not require supervision. Still, it necessitates downbeat estimation, which in our case were obtained using the MadMum toolbox, hence a deep neural network. Finally, this algorithm may be used with any representation learning algorithm. So you can use your favorite neural network to obtain a representation at the bar scale or at any scale, and then use the CBM to obtain segmentation. This could be exciting future research track. Thanks for listening, and I invite you to contact me if you have any questions.